Hello students, welcome to Python Pandas second part 2. As in the part 1 we have learned about data frame, how to create the data frame. In continuation with the same, we'll move to the next topic. And before moving to the next topic, let's see the today's agenda. Today's agenda is, we will see the different ways to create a data frame. Data frame attributes, then we will see the examples of using the data frame attributes, and after that we will see selecting or accessing data. Now let's see the different ways to create the data frame. So as we have discussed in the previous class also, let us revise that. There are four ways to create a data frame. One is by using a 2D dictionary. Second, we can create a data frame from the 2D ND array, that is a NumPy array. We can also create a data frame from 2D dictionary with the values as a series object. And we can also create a data frame object from another existing data frame object. So we will revise all the ways to create the data frame. See, the first method to create a data frame object from the 2D dictionary. See this example. In this example, the first our dictionary has been created containing the data of the employee, including the name, age, address and qualification. And all these data are stored in the form of dictionary, that is key values. The values are stored in a form of series. In a form of list. Now, from after creating this dictionary, we can convert this dictionary into data frame by using the syntax data frame object is equals to pd, that is a pandas dot data frame. It is a constructor and pass this dictionary as a argument. And this data frame object has been created. To display this data frame, we can display by giving the object name itself. So you can see here, the whole data has been organized and displayed in the form of data frame. Now, if I don't want all the data, if I want only two columns, that is a name and the qualification, then we can write like this also, print, or without the print also we can write df, that is a data frame object. In square bracket, we can give the two arguments, that is name, qualification, and we can get the output like this. Now, next, move to the next. Now we'll see the creating the data frame object from 2D ND array, that is a NumPy array. See this example. In this example, a array has been created with the name arr1 is equals to np, that is a NumPy dot array. And you can see here, this is a 2D array containing two rows with the four columns, the first row with the four columns and second row with the four columns. And if you want to see the shape of this, you can see the shape, two rows with the four columns. Now change this array into data frame, and for this create a data frame object. Data frame object, that is df1, is equals to pd dot data frame, and pass this arr1 as a argument. And now display it df1. You can see the default column indexes are given 0, 1, 2, 3, and default row numbers are also given, row index, that is 0 and 1. If you want this column to be user defined, we can give the user defined also. See this example. Again, the same object, create the same object df1 is equals to pd dot data frame, and you can see here the same array has been passed as an argument, and the columns, this is a user defined columns, and we can define like this, columns is equals to in the form of array or in a form of list we can give, that is first, second, third and fourth. Now this display this object df1, you can see the output. In the output, the columns names will be changed according to the user given columns. Now let's see creating a data frame object from 2D dictionary with the values as series of. In this example, we can see that there are three series type object, namely this population, average income, and per capita. And using these three series, we will create a dictionary, and with the help of this dictionary, we can create a data frame. So you can see here our population series has been created, pd.series. Similarly, average income is equal to pd.series, our value has been provided, and in the both the cases the index are same. You can see here third series, that is per capita is equal to average income divided by population, that will be calculated to calculated for each values. Now a dictionary has been created with the three index with the three keys 0, 1, and 2. On the first key the value is population, on the second key the value is average income, and the third key, that is 2, the value will be per capita. Now create a data frame object df3 with the dictionary 2 object. So df3 is equals to pd.dataframe dictionary as a argument. Now a df3 object has been created, that is a data frame object has been created. Now display it, you can we will get the output like this. So here you can see the default column names are coming according to the dictionary key, that is 0, 1, 2. We can also change this key either by the columns or while defining the dictionary itself. Instead of key 0, you can give the population. Instead of 1, you can give the average income, or instead of 2, you can give the per capita income. This way also we can change. Or another way is we can write like this: df3 is equals to pd.dataframe. The first argument will be dictionary, and we can give the columns as a series. And now we can display the output, and we'll get the output like this with the given columns. So this is the third way to create data frame from series. Now we'll see the creating a data frame object from another data frame object. This is a very easiest way. If and this method is only applied when we have any existing data frame and we want to create a new data frame from the existing data frame, we can apply this method. So you can see this example. We already have a data frame with the name df3 in a previous example. With that previous example, we can create a new data frame, that is df4 is equals to pd.dataframe, and pass the previous data frame as an argument. A new data frame has been created, df4. Now we display it, you can see the same output we are getting, but here the data frame object is changed, that is df4. So this is another method to create a data frame. And one thing has to be kept in mind, that is the argument should be the data frame object of another data frame. Now let's see data frame attributes. When a data frame is created, all the information related to it is available through attributes. Information like such as size, data type, etc. are all available through the attributes. To get the information, we have to use a syntax, and the syntax is data frame object dot attribute name. There are so many attributes are there. Let's see with these are the attributes of data frame. So first is the index, columns, axis, data types, size, shape, values, empty, endim, and t. So these all are used to get the or retrieve the different information or different type of information from the data frame. So like if we want to find the index of the data frame, we can use the index attribute. Similarly, if we have to get the information related to the columns, column levels or column names, we can use the columns attribute. Similarly, axis, data type, if we want the data types of the data frame object, then we can use data type. Similarly, there is a n dim, that is it will give the number of axes or number of arrays dimension, that is either 1, 2 or 3, or this t is another attribute that is used to transpose the index and the columns. We will see with the example. Let's see some examples of data frame attributes. Now if I have to retrieve a index, column or axis, now and or any data type of the columns, let's see some examples. This example shows how we can retrieve the index. So to retrieve the index, we can write data frame object, that is df4.index. We'll get all the index, you can see here, all the four index we will get, that is the name of the cities. Now similarly, if we want the columns, there are three columns were there, so df4.columns, we will get the columns name in the form of index. So you can see population, average income, per capita. If I want the axis, there are two axes, one for the columns and one for the rows. In the rows, there were the Delhi, Kolkata, Chennai and Mumbai cities were given, and in the columns it is given the population, average income and per capita. You can see here, so two indexes we are getting. In the first index we can see the city's name, that is a rows, and the second we are getting the columns. This way we get the axis. Now if we want the if we want the data types, we can write df4.datatypes. This is a attribute data type. Now we can see the population, the data type of the population is INT64, and average income is also INT64. Per capita is is in the decimal, so we are getting float 64. So this data types we are getting like this. Now we'll see some more examples of data frame objects. Now we'll see how to transpose a data frame. Let's see this example. This example shows how existing data frame can be changed. So you remember in the data frame 4, row was the city's name and the columns were the population, the second was the average income, and the third was the per capita. Now I have to create a new data frame df5 by transposing the previous one. So df5 is equals to df4.t. This will now transpose means changing the column to the rows and rows to columns. You can see here all the columns were changed to rows and all the rows were changed to columns. So this way the information has been transposed. Now let's see another example, NumPy representation of the data frame. That is, we can also represent a data frame as an array. So see this example. If we want in a form of array, simply what we have to write, we have to write df4.values. So dot values attribute will display the data frame in the form of array. You can see here it is a 2D array. Now we'll see selecting and accessing data. From a data frame object, we can extract or select the desired row and the column as per our requirement. So we'll see accessing rows and columns. So first we will start with selecting or accessing a column. Selecting and accessing a column is easy, and it can be done with this syntax. The syntax is data frame object, in a square bracket we have to give the column name. Or the second syntax is, we can also write data frame object dot column name, and either of the both can be used. See the example. In this example, this is our data frame, as you remember in the previous example. Now I have to, now from this data frame I want to access this population column, and for this we can either write by using the second index, second syntax also, or by using the first syntax also. Using the second syntax, that is data frame object dot column name, we can see this data frame object dot column name, so we will get all the information. Similarly, data frame in a square bracket, we can give the column name also, we can also get the same information in a by using this second method. Now again we'll see selecting and accessing multiple columns. If I have to access a multiple columns, what we have to select multiple columns, we can give a list having the multiple columns name inside the square brackets with our data frame object. Let's see the syntax. The syntax is data frame object in a square bracket. We can give the columns name in the form of list. You can see here two square brackets in the beginning, two square brackets in the last. That is, this square bracket, first square bracket is for data frame object and second square bracket is for creating a list of columns names. Let's see the example. This is our previous data frame that we have created, DF4, and on the basis of this data frame, a multiple columns can be retrieved or can be accessed. You can see here data frame object, that is DF4, in a square bracket we have created a list of two columns, that is population and per capita. You can see here the information are retrieved, two columns, the information of the two columns are retrieved together as a output. Now we'll see the selecting and accessing a subset from our data frame using row column name. As in a previous page, we have learned how to access the individual or the multiple columns. But what if we want to access two rows, access rows, and or a combination of rows and columns? For this, we can use another attribute, that is LOC attribute. That is LOC stand for location attribute, and the syntax for using this attribute is data frame object dot LOC. In this we have to give starting row colon end row comma start column colon end column, and through this we can either access a row or either we can access the column also, or either we can access the both. Okay, so we'll see one by one. So first of all, we'll see to access a row. How to access a row? For example, there is a rows containing four cities. I want to access a row row containing the row Delhi and the row Chennai. So you can see df4.loc Delhi. So it, and remember one thing, at the end comma with the colon sign should be there, and this will give the information of the row Delhi, that containing the population, average income per capita, similarly df4.loc Chennai, this will give the information of all three columns of Chennai row. Now if I have to access the multiple rows, you can see like this. So df4, that is data frame object dot loc, we can give first row colon the next row comma then at the last colon. So this will give the information including all the rows from Kolkata to Mumbai. So you can see in between the Kolkata and Mumbai there is a one more row, that is Chennai, so it is also coming. So it will include all the rows from the Kolkata row to the Mumbai row. Now we'll see one more example to access our selective columns. In a previous example we have seen to access the rows, now we'll see to access the selective columns. You can see this example to access the selective columns. So we are giving in a case of the column, at the beginning we have to give colon and comma. So df4.loc put a colon sign comma then column name, then up to which column I want we can give, that is population to per capita. So all the columns from the population two per capita will be included. So you can see the output. So all three columns are coming. But if we don't want all the columns, we can give we can give like this also. That is first column and the second column I want, I can give like this also. So this way we can get the output. Now to access a range of columns, so to give a range of columns, we can use the syntax that is a start row colon end row comma start column colon end column. You can see here, so we are giving the rows also. That is first row, starting row is Delhi, then ending row that is Mumbai, that is from beginning to end. And similarly, but for the column, starting column is population and the ending column is average income, so it will not include the per capita. This will include only these two columns. You can see the output here. Now the next we'll see under the selecting accessing data itself, obtaining a subset that is a slice from data frame using the numeric index. Sometimes our data frame object does not contain the rows or the column labels. Even if we may not remember them, in such cases we can extract the subset from the data frame using the row and column numeric index. So the syntax for using it, data frame object dot ILOC, that is integer location. ILOC means integer location. In a square bracket we have to give in the same way, that is start in row index and row index comma start column index colon end column index. Let's see the example. So in this example we are extracting a slice of the data frame DF4. So DF4 dot ILOC, we give the index. This is, this two index is for row, that is starting row index, ending row index. This is for the column, that is starting column index and ending column index. You can see the starting column index is 0, it will start from Delhi, and the index 2, that is it will end to Kolkata. Similarly here, starting index is 1, that is average income, and it will 2, 3, that is per capita. Now in the second example, now this index has been, the column index has been changed to 2, 1, 2, so that is it will include only the first index, that is 1, that is a average income. So you can see the output like this we will get. If you have any doubt, you can write in a comment and your doubt will be cleared. Now we'll see selecting or accessing individual values. To select or access an individual data value from a data frame, we can use any of the following method. The first method is either give the name of the row or the numeric index. The syntax will be data frame object dot column. In a column, in a square bracket, we can give the row name or the row index number. The second way is by using AT or IAT attribute. The syntax is data frame object dot AT, in a bracket we have to give the row name or column name. The syntax is data frame object dot AT, in a square bracket we have to give row name comma column name. The alternate of this is data frame object dot IAT. In case of IAT, we have to give the index. Remember this. This is integer at. In a square bracket, we have to give the numeric row index comma column index. See this example. Now I want the information or individual value stored in a population column in Delhi row. So you can write like this, df4.population, in a square bracket we have to give a row name, that is Delhi. So we'll get the information like this. Or we can write population
or you can give the index numeric index also. Similarly, the second example we can see. Now, using the at we can give, so df4.at Chennai, and you can give the average income. So you can see, so at Chennai and average income is the column name. So this is a row number, row name, and this is a column name. So on this row and under this column, this information is stored. Similarly, this can be accessed with the help of second index, that is IAT. In this, we have to give, instead of giving the name, we have to give the index, that is row index, comma, column index. So you can give, you can see the same value can be accessed through this index df4.iat2,1. The second column, second row is Chennai, and the first column is average income. You can see the same output we are getting. Next class, we will proceed with the next topic. Stay home, stay safe. Thank you.